We need to say a little bit more about the taskbar, because the taskbar I showed you earlier was the version that you saw in Windows Vista and earlier. In Windows 7, Microsoft changed the taskbar a little bit. What you should see in Windows 7 looks more like this. The main change here is that some of these buttons on the taskbar represent programs which aren't currently open. If you take a closer look at these buttons, you'll notice that some, like the one in the middle here, are highlighted. This highlighting indicates that it represents an actually open program. The button to its right, in contrast, isn't highlighted, indicating that that program is not currently open, but we're seeing it here because this program has been pinned to the taskbar, so its button is always visible and we can click on it to actually run the program. This program button on the left, you'll notice, has highlighting, but it looks a bit different. This highlighting indicates that there are actually multiple windows for this program. And if you were to click on this button, you would see little thumbnails of all of its windows, and you then can click on one of these thumbnails to select that window. Now, if you're wondering how to pin or unpin programs from the taskbar, you can do so simply by right-clicking on a program's button in the taskbar or in the Start menu, and you'll see in the Context menu an option to pin or unpin that program. Also note that you can reorder these buttons in the taskbar simply by clicking and dragging them. You may have noticed that the taskbar includes a section of smaller icons off to the right next to where the time is displayed. This area of the taskbar is called the system tray, or sometimes called the notification area. The idea behind the system tray is that there are some programs we wish to keep running, but we don't need to interact with them on a frequent basis. So, for such programs, it's not appropriate that they have an always visible window and that they have a button on the taskbar. Instead, they just get reduced to a little icon off in the system tray. So, for example, there's a little speaker icon in the system tray for volume control. If you click that, you get a little slider, which you can slide up and down to adjust the volume on your system. Windows has this concept of what it calls the clipboard. The idea of the clipboard is that it is a program-independent place where we can put data, and then we can take the data on the clipboard and then copy the data back to other programs. Most commonly, this data is just text, but it can be image data, or it can be, as we'll see in the next unit, it could be either files or folders, among other things. The way we use the clipboard is with three operations called copy, paste, and cut. A copy operation, as the name implies, copies data to the clipboard. A paste operation copies the data from the clipboard into a program, and then the cut operation is a variant on copy. It's the same thing, except after copying, it will delete the original data. So cut is what you use when you wish to move something rather than copy it. So, for example, say I'm editing text in Microsoft Word, and also at the same time I'm editing text in Notepad. If I wish to copy this text from Word to Notepad, I first highlight the text I wish to copy, then right-click on the highlighted text, and then in the context menu I select Copy. That copies this highlighted text to the clipboard. I then go into Notepad, and I place the keyboard cursor where I wish to insert the text. I then right-click there and select Paste in the context menu. That copies the text from the clipboard to right here where I have the keyboard cursor. Now, very importantly, we only copied the data from the clipboard. The data is still there in the clipboard. So, if I move the keyboard cursor and paste again, it inserts the text once more. So, in fact, as long as something remains on the clipboard, you can paste it as many times as you like. Also, very importantly, we can paste data from the same program which we originally copied that data. So, I can go to Word here and paste this text as many times as I like. So here now, the text is repeated 3 times. The cut operation, again, is the same thing as copying, except then it's like you deleted the text after you copied it. So here, if I highlight it was the best of times, and then select cut, the text disappears. But then if I paste, it reappears where I have my keyboard cursor, and I can paste it as many times as I like. And finally, be clear that the clipboard only holds one thing, so every time you copy or cut, you are effectively overwriting whatever was previously in the clipboard. So, here if I copy, it was the worst of times, but then copy it was the best of times. Well, that was the last thing I copied, so when I paste, it pastes it was the best of times. Because that's the text which is on the clipboard when I pasted.